We're coming to you this week from Sobo Central in Mumbai, the perfect setting for our first story. Holiday season is here and the first festival around the corner is Diwali. That time of the year when everyone gets together to do one thing in particular, send their prayers up to Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth. Well, our showcase this week is designed to make sure that she sits up and takes notice of your prayers.
Thriving business for these puja stalls selling their items before the evening darshan. If this startup has its way though, these guys might have some serious competition.
Some ghee used to light a diya, haldi, kumkum, the Ganesha Lakshmi Murti, and a kalash filled with Gangajal. All the ingredients for your Diwali puja in one compact box. Symbiosis MBA graduate Prakash Munra certainly had the gods on his side. But even this business idea, which involved the selling of branded puja kits, needed some encouragement. It came from some unexpected quarters.
There was this contest organized by the company ITC, which was called Mera Gaon Mera Desh, where they wanted a business plan which would already align with their existing businesses. And since ITC was into Mangaldeep Agarbati, I looked upon that area of ITC and I made a business plan which was to do with branded puja items.
His plan got rejected by ITC, but he was more successful in other business plan contests where he earned a total of 3 lakhs. His father loaned him an additional 3 lakhs, which made up his seed capital of 6 lakhs, which was spent on product design and on sampling. Sacred Moments and its brand of blessings was thus born.
Prakash moved to his father's existing office space on Momalai Road, where as you can see, chaos is all around. Amidst the chaos though, a network of wholesale suppliers and the advantage of the area's location as a hub for domestic cargo.
Inherent advantages of a wholesale market, which Prakash no doubt exploited. The segment being completely unstructured, the chief challenge was identifying suppliers who would provide a consistency in quality. Prakash spent a complete year in this pursuit, identifying the multiple wholesalers from whom the various products could be sourced.
This is called Havan Samagri, basically used all over the world for Havan. This has called almost 32 items which I blended and make up superior product. This product is called Sindoor, basically used for Tilak. It has non-lead item which is especially used for export quality.
The flagship product, the Diwali Blessings Kit, constitutes 33 items sourced from various parts of India.
The ghee in a sachet pack, it comes from a place near Tirupur. Then you have this crafted coconut which comes from Chhapra in Bihar. You have Gangajal, which obviously comes from Gangotri. This kalash, it comes from Mathura in Bihar, which is the manufacturing center.
Apart from the Diwali kit, Sacred Moments also has kits for Holi, Namaz, a Diya kit and a Ghar Pravesh kit used for housewarming. Prakash's initial plan was to retail the puja kits across multiple stores. But this soon changed after realizing the ground realities.
Since mine is a labor-oriented product, I cannot manufacture the product in such a mega scale. And retail would also entail a lot of risk in terms of sale on consignment and a lot of return kits after the occasion.
Sacred Moments has over 45 corporate gifting clients, some of their key clients being Nicholas Pirimal and Reliance Capital. A majority of their repeat orders come from pharma companies and builders like Neil Kant Builders, for whom a puja kit is a welcome break from the usual.
People get sweets and dry fruits and crackers from the whole world, and chandi and sona and is all passe now. So this is something which is very, very different, and it was compact, so it was not a difficult thing to deliver along with a sweets packet or a dry fruit packet.
So far, the only marketing for Sacred Moments has been through the internet and by taking part in corporate gifting exhibitions. The firm hit revenues of 1 crore in its last financial year, with 80% of its revenues coming from corporate gifting. The space, not being a capital intensive one, allowed the business to break even within its first 3 months of operation, hence completely funding its own growth. for the future, Prakash is looking to expand into large format retail stores and the export markets. With this, he hopes his product will have a well-defined space in the mind of the consumer.
Think of festivals and think sacred moments.
Think festivals and think of sacred moments. With all the early success he's been having in his venture, Prakash might well have found an answer to all his prayers.
As sales have soared, Prakash has found that his puja kits are an extremely popular gift to give to high net worth individuals. Individuals who ostensibly have every other luxury. For me, I finally found that perfect gift to give my grandmom.
Blessings also has a special set of Diya kits out only for this Diwali. They're also looking to further foray into international markets. So it looks like Blessings at least is fully into festive mode.